Love was in the air in 2021. From the emotional climaxes of romantic film favorites to stirring period stories with characters who took our breath away, there were a lot of films that brought us the goods this year. So, as we think back over a year's worth of magical, romantic moments, let's take a look at all the best kisses on Netflix in 2021. There's no time like the end times to find the one you love. In Adam McKay's Don't Look Up, Jennifer Lawrence's Kate DiBiase has the unfortunate privilege of being named for the planet-killing comet that she discovers to be on a direct collision course with Earth, a comet nobody seems to care about. One person who does appreciate Kate's sense of urgency is a young man named Yul, played by Timothée Chalamet. Even in the worst of times, these two manage to form a real bond with one another and find forever love, no matter how short forever might be for both of them, or how casually their romance begins.
Fuck it, we're all gonna die.
In The Dig, a drama about the historic excavation of the real-life Sutton Hoo site, there are some very powerful emotional experiences that coincide with the discovery of an ancient Anglo-Saxon burial site in Britain. For Lily James's Peggy Piggott, just as she's helping to unearth some true treasures, her marriage to her husband is going underground fast. After a series of round rejections by her spouse, Peggy finds comfort in the arms of the very dashing Rory Lomax, portrayed by Johnny Flynn, who's more than happy to shower her with affection. Not only are their kisses intensely romantic, but they're also backdropped by some true wonders of the world. The last letter from your lover brings the heat to not one, but two different timelines, as Felicity Jones's modern-day journalist Ellie works with Nabon Rizwan's Rory to track down a treasure trove of old love letters from a couple who affectionately call themselves Jay and Boot. Their sudden and sweeping romance makes for many moments of emotional resonance as they steal away to savor their love in scenic locales, all while the modern romance between Ellie and Rory builds to a heartwarming, rain-soaked crescendo. Army of the Dead fans get to take a deep dive into the storied history of Matthias Schweighofer's quirky safecracker extraordinaire Ludwig Dieter in Army of Thieves. Only this time, he's going by his given name of Sebastian, and he's being recruited into an international ring of thieves long before the Las Vegas heist in Army of the Dead. The group's ringleader, Natalie Emmanuel's Gwendolyn, brings him into the tight-knit group. After Sebastian pulls off a particularly impressive heist, the two almost give in to the chemistry that's forming between them before being interrupted. So when they finally do get the chance to lock lips, it really is a thrilling payoff that you've been waiting for the whole movie. Elle Evans and Noah Flynn experience some major highs and lows in the third and final chapter of their love story, The Kissing Booth 3. After a moment of conflict that leaves Elle questioning what their relationship is really made of, Noah pulls off another of his grand gestures by showing up to the diner she works at after hours. The incredibly romantic dance assures them both that what they have is real and worth fighting for. And, of course, the kiss as they seal the deal gives audiences yet another reason to melt over this adorable screen couple. The final installment of the To All the Boys I've Loved Before trilogy, Always and Forever, offers a bittersweet conclusion to the saga of Lara Jean and Peter. In perhaps the greatest of his signature grand gestures, Peter surprises Lara Jean at her father's wedding by presenting her with a letter offering to make a new agreement about how they'll make their love last, and offering a heart-swelling reminder of all they've been through.
I had no clue then that you would become who you are now, the most important person in my life.
Of course, no contract like this would be complete without sealing it with a kiss. In He's All That, a modern reimagination of the 1999 teen classic She's All That, it doesn't take long for sparks to fly between Addison Rae's Paget Sawyer and Tanner Buchanan's Cameron Queller, even though their relationship begins because of a bet.
Is that terrible?
Yeah, kind of.
Even though she initially has ulterior motives for paying so much attention to Cameron, Paget is truly charmed by the person she's come to know along the way and shows her genuine affection for him with a kiss. It's not the only swoony smooch these two will share over the course of their love story, but it's certainly an unforgettable moment in their journey together.
Why am I here?
Because I trust you.
George Lindeberg Jr. and Debbie Ryan shine in Night Teeth. Their characters, Benny and Blair, are from two very different worlds. Benny is a simple college student, while Blair is one of two ravishing vampires Benny is driving from party to party throughout town. Blair proves to him that there's a real beating heart beneath her undead exterior when Benny is confronted by some cruel classmates in front of a nightclub, and she decides to step in.
Look at it. Looks like a butler or something. Oh shit, I was right?
Although the gesture is meant to put on something of a show, it's clear from both of their immediate reactions that this won't be the last time they plant one on one another.
Benny has his hands full tonight.
Love crashes over the young couple Sarah and Lorenzo during summer camp in the Italian romantic drama Caught by a Wave. As swept up in their summer love as they are, Sarah still doesn't trust her beau enough to tell him about the degenerative disease that affects her mobility until her condition becomes too hard to conceal. All of their kisses are sweet and meaningful, but the one that truly makes all the hearts swell is when they're reunited in the sea during a sailing mishap. And their first reaction to being swept into the water is to express their love with their lips and a pair of giant smiles. New love gets a major boost from the beyond in Afterlife of the Party. The romantic comedy stars Victoria Justice as a social butterfly named Cassie, who dies during her birthday week but gets a chance to return to Earth for 5 days to make things right with the people she left behind. One of the people on her list is her best friend Lisa, who'd been by her side since childhood but grew tired of her hard partying lifestyle. Cassie and Lisa have some serious healing to do, but it doesn't hurt that Lisa has met a certain someone who might just be a dream come true in her kind neighbor Max.
You look... wow.
You look wow yourself.
When the time finally comes for the two to confess their very alive feelings for one another, the two bring a little piece of heaven to the living world with their sumptuous smooches. Some people say that you can't love anyone else until you love yourself, and that certainly seems to be the case for Kevin Quinn's Will Hawkins in A Week Away. After attending a religious summer camp as a bit of penance for a juvenile crime, Will finds that he likes the place, and more importantly, the people there, a lot more than he expected. However, when his troubled past comes to light, his first instinct is to run away. And sadly, the girl he makes such beautiful music with, Bailey Madison's Avery, can't convince him to come back. But when he does decide to return, Will and Avery are finally able to share a kiss in front of all their friends as Will embraces being cared about and caring for himself at last.
Thanks for coming after me.
Thank you for coming back.
I'm so sorry that I...
It's something of a Christmas miracle that the third movie in the Princess Switch series, Romancing the Star, turns the troublesome Fiona into someone we can all like. The romantic comedy introduces us to Fiona's childhood confidant, Peter Maxwell, who helps Fiona retrieve a priceless Vatican artifact for her cousin Margaret. Along the way, their shared past comes back into play and they both realize how much they care for each other before finally capping a lifetime of close friendship with a much-deserved happy ending. Andrew Garfield's portrayal of the great Jonathan Larson in Tick, Tick, Boom is electric and compelling as he navigates music, theater, and a tumultuous relationship with his girlfriend, Susan. Though there are questions about his and Susan's future together, the devotion and respect they each have for one another is never in doubt. So it's a beautiful moment when the two decide to put aside their many concerns and just enjoy each other for a quiet talk and a tender kiss on the rooftop.
I could just watch you dancing forever.
Love and Monsters is a heart-stopping action-adventure story centered on Joel, a young man who finds the love of his life in Amy, right before a catastrophe strikes the world and turns all the cold-blooded creatures into giant monsters. But before this game-changing blight first strikes, Joel and Amy have at least one beautiful moment together. During a drive-in date on a scenic overlook, the two lock lips one last time before the apocalypse begins.
Best summer of my life.
There's a reason Joel spends the next 7 years dreaming of Amy. Their connection in the before times is absolutely undeniable here. In Yes Day, Allison and Carlos use their hilarious Day of Yeses to prove to themselves that they're still the fun, hip folks that first fell in love with each other. As they both give in to their children's wildest dreams for the day, Carlos gains some serious sympathy for how much flack his wife has been getting to keep their house in order. When the two are in custody together after a carnival game gone wrong, Carlos admits that he's let Allison handle the harder parts of parenting, and he vows to step up and be her true partner from here on out. That promise is exactly what Allison needs to hear.
Te amo, mi amor.
Y yo te amo. Muchísimo.
Single All the Way gives an all-new definition to the concept of being in the friend zone. The film centers on Peter, who invites his best friend and roommate, Nick, to join him on a trip back home to New Hampshire to visit his family for the holidays. After Peter's family tries hard to play matchmaker for the two, Nick ultimately confesses his true love for Peter. His affections aren't immediately returned, but just before they part ways, Peter finally returns the favor and decides to show his own feelings for Nick once and for all. Almost no couple has a picture-perfect origin story, but in Love Hard, there's a lot of confusion to conquer between Natalie Bauer and Josh Lynn. Josh meets Natalie through a fake online profile and gets blindsided when Natalie decides to make a surprise trip to see him for the holidays, and realizes Josh isn't who he said he was.
Natalie? What are you doing here?
However, the two slowly find that the real reason they first connected had nothing to do with an alias or feigned profile picture. They actually have a lot in common. Once Natalie is able to realize that her truest feelings are for Josh, she puts their shared love of movies to good use by replicating the iconic moment from Love Actually to admit that she cares for him, leading to an epic kiss and a truly happy ending. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.